Hi everyone, good day. Today I'm going to educate you on pasture and forage crops. Livestock, especially ruminants, feed on grasses in pastures. Any area which is used for grazing farm animal is called a pasture. Good pastures are made up of good quality grasses, a proportion of legumes and a few wheat. In all pastures, overgrazing must be avoided. If so many animals graze in an area of pasture, they trample and destroy the plants. The soil surface is consequently subjected to erosion. Types of pastures. Natural pastures. Natural pastures need no cultivation. It is the main vegetation of the savanna areas. Grazing animals eat crops at the growing point of the plant, which cause new shoots to appear. Lee pastures. These are temporary pastures. The land is prepared and legume and grass mixture is seeded on the land. Lee pastures are fertilized by the urine and feces of grazing animals. Lee pasture often serve as part of a long-term crop rotation. Artificial pastures. Here, a permanent pasture is established on a newly prepared land. It is usually maintained by careful grazing, fertilization, weeding, and reseeding if bare patches occur. Artificial pasture has been conveniently subdivided into other forms of pasture as follows. Permanent pasture. Any pasture which sustains grazing for up to 3 years is a permanent pasture. Rotational pasture. When the pasture is divided into sections used in rotation for grazing livestock, it is called a rotational pasture. Supplemental pasture. This is a pasture established when special selection of grasses, legumes, and wheat to provide needed nutrients when other forms are deficient. Now, the factors affecting distribution, establishment, and productivity of pastures. The fertility of the soil. Grasses grown on poor soils tend to be coarse, fibrous, and of low nutritional value for animals. Level of grazing. Overgrazing must be avoided. If too many animals graze an area, plants are destroyed and the soil is exposed to agents of erosion. Level of rainfall. In areas of rainfall, pastures may be dominated by grasses which are drought resistant and which are only palatable to the animals in the young stage. As the grasses become older, they become coarse and fibrous. Time should be allowed for a plot to recover between grazing period, and if possible, fertilizer should be added. Weeding of unwanted plants is carried out. Care should be taken to avoid destruction of the pasture species by burning. Care should be taken to see that shrubs and trees are not established in the grazing land by avoiding overstocking. And then the characteristics of a good forage crop. It should be highly palatable. It should be of high nutritional value. It should be easily digestible. It should be resistant to trampling, and it should reproduce reliable and yield well. Let me stop here for today. See you next time.